Alright, so now it's about time to add logging to our Python scripts. So let's take our previous code, modify it, and log it in Tensorboard. So in this video we are going to learn about Tensorboard and how we can use it to inspect the data that was generated during training. So here you see the exact same code as before from unit 5.4 and 5.5, but now we are going to take a look at the Tensorboard logger. So if you haven't installed Tensorboard, you can do pip install Tensorboard here and then install it directly from the terminal. Now assuming you have Tensorboard installed, you can make a little modification here to specify where you want to save the log files. So for example, you can set it to desktop, but it doesn't really matter where you set it as long as it's some directory on your computer that you can find. And by the way, by default, Lightning will save it in the current folder you are executing this code. Now this is all we need because Lightning will log things for us by default because we defined the logging steps as part of the Lightning module here, if you recall. So we have the log steps for the training loss, the training accuracy, and the validation set loss, validation set accuracy, and the test accuracy. So let's actually run this code. While this code is running, you can actually already start logging. However, we can also make a new terminal here while the code is running and then add our TensorBoard command. So we can do TensorBoard logdir, so to specify where the logs are. Since I set it to my desktop, I have to now specify the desktop, and then it's called Lightning logs by default, and I can execute this code. And TensorBoard will run in my browser, so I can open this here in my browser. So let's go to my web browser and open it here. So here I can now see TensorBoard logging the results. Notice that it's called version 0 because if I execute the code multiple times, instead of overwriting the old results, it will add a new entry here called version_1. And then we can see the epochs. Of course, that's not very interesting. The epochs go up from 0 to 9, so it's usually not very useful. But we can see the test accuracy, which is just a single data point, so it's also not super interesting. What's more interesting is, for example, the training set accuracy here. So here we can see the training set accuracy, and below, we can also take a look at the training set loss and so forth, which nicely goes down. So actually this is a smoothened version, so we can actually smoothen the plots, which is also a nice feature. And what's very nice about TensorBoard is that you can visualize the model training results during the training. You don't have to wait until the model finished training. So if your model trains for many days or many hours, you can during the training already visualize the loss, which ideally should go down, of course. So in this video we saw how we can use TensorBoard to visualize the results that are created during training. In the next video we will take a look at an alternative approach using a CSV logger to look at the data that is generated during training. Thank you.